Hey, this is Fly Guy, San Diego Comic-Con. It's the final last minutes of this con. It's just closing down. I've just braved the craziness that was the Funko booth. Absolute insanity. People offered me huge wads of money just to get exclusives, even though there was nothing left. People were buying every single thing they could off these shelves. Absolute insane bedlam. All of this shit is going to be flipped on eBay without a doubt. I've already seen people buy customs from Funko, limited editions from Funko already, and installs literally just a few feet away, slap stickers on them of $200. They're not going to sell for that, but it just shows you the absolute insanity of this con. It's been wonderful, but at the same time, it's absolutely psychotic. However, what we're going to do here just in the last few minutes, I'm going to take you through, I'm just going to shut up because the audio probably may not pick up, but I'm going to take you through just some of the stalls very quickly, and we'll get a quick look at the con, and you can get a look at some of the stalls. Just think of it as a bit of a walkthrough. So it's about the only time we could actually get through this and walk through it. There's been so much traffic, people everywhere. So anyway, hope this is useful for you, and leave a comment below. Just to add, you may not get to see everything in this video, and I may not spend long on items, but just pause and have a look if you want. I'm just trying my best to make sure you get to see a good whole walkthrough, I guess. So there's the Warner Brothers in DC, one of their main stands. Lots and lots of vendors. The halls generally split in smaller vendors, and then right smack in the middle tends to be some of the larger ones. Bandai, Star Wars, there's a Lucasfilm pavilion. But you can see how deep some of these alleys go. Have to see, the food here at San Diego Comic-Con is shockingly bad. Make sure you come if you're coming here with some lots of supplies, because it utterly sucks. Thank God the Starbucks in here, but apart from that, there's not much. This was a nice little Walking Dead zombie kind of feature, that there was real live zombies in there. There's one just now. You could get on stage with the Muppets in this studio here. Again, everything is just about closing. BBC America had a good stall selling Doctor Who, Orphan Black.
Quiet!
Obviously lots of trailers, lots of TV shows getting shown here, lots of games being announced, lots of posters, lots of comics. This is still the main chunk of the hall here. Square Enix, lots of PlayArts Kai stuff. Let's go down here quickly. Doctor Who, of course. So sorry this is a little wobbly and disconcerting as the video goes on, but hey, you're going to look inside San Diego Comic-Con. Ash versus the Evil Dead going on in there. Warcraft, Konami. And there's Square Enix. A lot of the shelves now are kind of empty. I've taken some photographs of this stuff, but beautiful things like Marvel Universe, Iron Man. Just some amazing figures they had on display. Very little left now, it has to be said. This is the Adult Swim tent. Weta Workshop. Clearly some giveaways here. Mugs, not exactly something you want to throw. I braved the gentle giant booth this morning, or 3D systems really as they've now been called, and that was hell, but managed to get something for a friend of mine. Let's have a quick look. My foot for scale. Gigantic ass Java. And here's the Hasbro booth. I want to show you one thing quickly in here, and that is the two key dioramas. Again, I've made some videos separately of these, so check out the channel and you will see these. But we'll go a quick flow through here just to show you. Again, there's a separate video that shows all of this in detail, but pretty amazing Marvel Legends diorama. Lots of cool characters in here, lots of them brand new, lots of them old, a few customs in there. Thunder, She-Hulk, X-Men, Thor, Loki, lots of stuff going on in this. Lots of stuff underneath as well. Little AIM soldiers doing something with each other.
Yeah, the giant man.
And a little Deadpool in there chilling out. Has to be said, one of the things that Hasbro really don't seem to do well is stands. A lot of the figures have either fallen over or a little bit wobbly. We can see here the Ahsoka's nearly fallen over. And Luke, now raise the question in our Q&A, which we'll have broadcast. Did you see another figure falling over? This gorgeous big TIE fighter. We did a separate video for this, flying right inside Steve, one of the key, in fact he's the design director here for Hasbro. Let me get a look inside the vehicle earlier on when we did the Q&A. Pretty cool stuff. There's Jango again, we get separate high-res images. And of course that Force Awakens trooper, which caused such a panic at the booth. The Black Series Risk game, seen first at Celebration Anaheim, but here in its full flesh. And even more, the new Inquisitor, Captain Rex, and a few others. And of course, current Black Series and some Play School stuff. And the other big display was this one. This huge, if you can see it with all the glare, TIE fitted display from the movie with working effects and clouds of stormtroopers. And again, stands. We need stands, Hasbro. They're using Protec stands here for the figures, which don't really fit 6-inch figures, but just shows you the lack of stands. We need them. There's a little sneak more at the TIE fitter pilot. These troopers look fantastic. These things are going to have the crap bought out of them for army builders. So this is why we believe the new Black Series will have 6 packs instead of 4 packs. You'll see 6 of each figure in the case. The case will be 6. Here's Mark in the background from Tops, very nice gent. We interviewed him and we've got an audio interview, a separate audio interview with him. And this is part of this larger Lucasfilm Pavilion, giant Furbacker. Countdown to September the 4th. And if we look a little further up here, there's something which is pretty special. And I was commending Hasbro on this earlier on. They did a gigantic, and I mean gigantic, life-size Hulkbuster, which we can see there. Just absolutely huge. Someone standing in the front getting the photograph taken.
Thank you for attending Comic-Con International 2015. We hope you've all had a wonderful time. We'll see you next year.
Lots of cheers as the end of show. It was something pretty special. There was quite a few things left in stock. Here you can see some of the things on screen. But of course, once that Force Awakens tripper went, all the queues dissipated. Some beautiful stuff from Chronicle here. Incredibly good looking Arnie. Lots of cool, cool, cool props, including this one from Men in Black. A tiny little piece inside. It's just awesome. There may be some madness as the queues come out of here, so apologies. There's the Batman versus Superman Hot Wheels car. The main Star Wars pavilion over there with Heart Universe, Petco, lots of other Star Wars vendors inside. Mattel had their Batman versus Superman stuff. You can hear Star Wars in the background. Lego. Mega Bloks, SpongeBob SquarePants, lots of issues with LEGO this year, trying to get in queues and get product. Friend I was with really struggled to get stuff, but managed in the end. Beautiful little mosaics up there that are spinning around in the background, that LEGO panel. At one turn, you'll see there's Wonder Woman in her movie reference. In just a second, if you look a little closer, it's actually her minifig version as well. If you squint a little, you'll see it, but it's beautifully done. Does that for Batman, Superman, and Wonder Woman. And some of the other figures we had here at the LEGO booth. Force Awakens Trooper. Lots of bays to build stuff, and this gigantic ass. Gigantic Hulk Buster in LEGO. With Hulk. Hulk smash! This caused quite a stir, this thing here, when it was revealed. Something pretty special. Okay, a few more things just to quickly show you. Dark Horse IDW Comics. A few other things. Let's see what else we can show you very quickly. As you can see, we're only halfway through the hall. If you look at the numbers up at the top, this ran from about 4,500 all the way down. Once we get to about 1,800, you'll find the majority of it is just comic vendors, smaller vendors. Hopefully we'll get to reach the sideshow booth and show you more. Again, we have separate videos for just about everything I could manage to get into queues. This was the Marvel stand here. This was, we had the gorgeous Agent Carter in there at one point today. And lots of freebies, Lando comics given away as everybody piling through the remains of the goodies. There we go. Postcards, I guess. Lots of little postcards and giveaways and I don't know, guitar picks for Iron Man 3. So, very strange stuff. This is a good time to be here for some freebies. Some giveaways and cards. Have a little look. Thank you, man. There you go. So there's lots of little cool things like this. Little giveaways and collector cards. And it's always a good time to be at the show. They did some Ant-Man props, we had some Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. stuff going on. Tons of stuff. Now there's still some things here. We're coming up to the sideshow and Hot Toys booth. They did a joint booth. Had a few Hot Toys questions for them. They did not know, so it was really sideshow stuff. Some very glamorous sideshow stuff, but didn't quite know some of the details. Now I've got individual videos again. We've looked at all these Hot Toys and Star Wars, but there's some amazing reveals that was here. Again, all these figures we've done a bit more of a pulled over, quarter scale. The gigantic TIE fighter, the sideshow Hot Toys version, Back to the Future, that TIE fighter, the Millennium Falcon cockpit. There's Ant-Man at the back, there's Iron Man, all sorts of stuff. Lots of promo codes were given away at the sideshow. The DC booth was rather cool this year. Lots of, you can just see in the distance there, the Batman suit from Batman vs. Superman. We watched the Batman vs. Superman trailer revealed here for the first time. Wonder Woman, Superman. Lots of cool giveaways, lots of little teases about Arrow and The Flash. What else have we got? And this is where we kind of get 1900s of the aisle, where we kind of tend to split into smaller vendors. And I mean, some of them are real small, some of them are big, but it's pretty much comic vendors. There's some of the sideshow babes in their beautiful little dresses. All very glamorous, very attractive. We had a good conversation with someone who was doing Christian comics. And they had turned Jesus into a superhero. So you name it, it was happening at Comic-Con. Heavy Metal, a very popular magazine and art. Lunch. Little arcade games. Lots and lots of comic vendors. Have to say the prices were astronomical for some of them. Mile High Comics lived up to, unfortunately, their name. But in saying that, what they were charging in price, they had in great knowledge and great customer service. So, you know, more power to them. They had a lot of stock, so you don't often get that stuff. But this is it. Smaller vendors, a lot of t-shirts, a lot of books, individual stalls, a lot of artists selling stuff. People just trying to pimp their wares. And a lot of vendors selling toys, Funko Pop, this kind of stuff. As you can see. Look, I hope this has been kind of useful. There's probably not much more to show you as we slow down. There's a few things here and there. Some toy vendors selling some stuff. You may get a few things cheap before the con ends, but literally they'll be kicking us out very, very soon. So as we come up towards the end, it kind of gets into t-shirts. Sorry. A lot of classic older comics as well. A lot of people selling things like insurance for comics. lot of trade paperbacks. Everywhere you went, there was tons of trade paperbacks, old posters. And again, I'm not going up and down each aisle, but you can get an idea. Lots of plush, meh, posters, cool posters, as I mentioned, Hot Toys, there's a few Hot Toys vendors. Again, really, you would be mad to buy a Hot Toy here because the prices were mad. We've got some good prices on stuff that you could see some Atto figures. They were brand new on sale, some Gremlins, some good prices. So there was some good stuff around here. We had some vendors selling the Black Series figures, not quite as good as maybe a $14 Cody from Darkseid Toys or Hannon Stormtrooper armor that they've been selling, but we did see some stuff at like $23, $24 and things, so it's not always a con at Comic-Con. So lots of comics, we're coming up to the end. There was video games, Super Mario Maker, there's a lot of video games up at this end. Some very interesting stuff from Skylanders and Capcom, Street Fighter V, and that's pretty much it. We've given you a real 360, whereas we reached the wall there, and there's all the way back down. I hope this has been useful for you. It's been amazing for me. I don't know whether I'll brave this again, because it's a hell of a con. In some ways, it's expensive. A lot of food is not very good. You've got to spend a lot of money on food and transport. But you know what? If you only do one thing in your life, you definitely need to come here to experience this. The queues, the smells, the free smells, the noise, and the good fun. I made a ton of friends here, a lot of really nice people here. So I hope that was useful. Please do subscribe if you're brand new to the channel so we can give you lots of other cool videos straight into your inbox. That's it from me for San Diego Comic-Con 2015. Leave a comment below and I'll get back to you soon as. Thanks.